All right, let me ask you to take your Bibles, please, and turn with me to the book of Joshua. In the Old Testament, the book of Joshua, we'll be looking in chapter 5 of Joshua in just a few minutes. But before we do, this is another series, another message in the series on the road to revival. And you know, in God's Word, there are several different analogies for revival. In the Bible, it talks about rivers of living water. It talks about the former and latter rain. Rain is always one of God's symbols of revival. Manna from heaven can be a symbol of revival. Pentecost, when fire came down, and cloven tongues as a fire set on each one of them, symbol of revival. God's fire is always a good symbol of revival. But you know, the one analogy of revival that I've always liked in God's Word is the analogy of standing on holy ground. Because when we experience real revival, that's what it is. It's an experience of standing on holy ground. And of course, by definition, the definition of holy ground is anywhere God is. If you're in the presence, a manifest presence of Almighty God, you're automatically standing on holy ground. Because wherever God is, that's where you find holy ground. We'll begin reading with verse 13 of the 5th chapter of Joshua, where the inspired, infallible, inerrant Word of God says, "And it came to pass when Joshua was by Jericho, that he lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, there stood a man over against him with his sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua went unto him and said unto him, Art thou for us or for our adversaries? And he said, Nay, but as captain of the host of the Lord am I now come. And Joshua fell on his face to the earth and did worship and said unto him, What saith my Lord unto his servant? And the captain of the Lord's host said unto Joshua, Loose thy shoe from off thy foot, for the place whereon thou